Bonjour à tous et bienvenue.
Hi everybody, I'm Loïc Lacroix. Welcome to this new tutorial from www.myvpschool.com. Today we keep going with the Antares collection because they just released the brand new version of the famous AutoTune, the AutoTune Live version.
Un nouvel outil qui est un AutoTune en fait. Un autotune, mais version live.
Alors, so, why do we need a live version? The reason is simple. With the previous versions of autotune, if you try to record while listening yourself, you had latency. So, with the time lag, it wasn't very practical to record with autotune on. It was almost impossible to record and to listen your voice with the effect at the same time. So now this is corrected with the new version of AutoTune, AutoTune Live. Just to let you know, if you purchase the complete version of AutoTune, the live version is included in. For the live version only, the price is around 250 euros, and for the full version, it's around 400 euros. With the complete version, you will get this function, which allows you to work in real time, which is a huge improvement. So, to show you from A to Z how does this plugin works, I composed a little song as usual, and we will listen the difference between the export without the autotune on and with the autotune on.
L'export avec autotune et l'export sans autotune. Allez, c'est parti.
Let's go!
De piano au départ.
Some piano first.
Donc là on est sans
autotune. Here there is no autotune. You can make your online show. You can show your face at all, face to face. You really know. It's only 'cause you're alone. But what have you do say at all? So you can see here that the transition between each note is not very precise. There is no autotune, it's a real singing without any correction. Now we're gonna listen with the autotune on, so you will see that if we use it sparingly, we can get a perfect result. And if we push it, we can get the same voice effect as Future, Travis Scott, Young Thug, etc. Everybody uses it now, it became very popular in the musical scene. Like a lot. So now we will listen the same song again, but this time with a small correction on, a smaller correction than the examples I just mentioned. But of course, in this tutorial, we will learn how to use autotune in a very actual way. Let's listen.
Je vous fais écouter.
There is a mastered version and an unmastered version. It's not the same kick also. Here we can see that the singing is very corrected, and obviously that's what we want with autotune. So let's go in the project of our song without autotune and without the mastering.
Donc le master était vraiment fait à la va-vite. C'est la musique.
That's the song with nothing on.
Du coup, alors, comment ça fonctionne
AutoTune? So, how does AutoTune works? AutoTune is the plugin who goes straight into the signal, so we use it as an insert and never as a send. Maybe except in some very specific cases, but it's very rare.
Donc, je vais par exemple.
Here, I go to my chorus track.
Et je vais dans la section insert.
And I go into the insert section. I left a blank for my autotune. If that's not the case for you, it's very simple to move the plugins as you wish.
On le fait déplacer.
It's very simple to move the plugins.
Donc, autotune.
In general, autotune, even with a stereo treatment, we will use a mono record. And we will place autotune in first position at the top.
Autotune, on va toujours le mettre d'abord. Pourquoi?
Parce Why? Que, par exemple, because si if, for example, we use a mono to stereo plugin, we'll get a larger voice in this space. That's what I've done here.
On voit que là, en effet,
we can see a left-right movement. The singing is moving a bit because of the mono to stereo.
D'ailleurs, il faut savoir,
I use this plugin a lot, and I also use Antares Avox Duo. I talked about it in a previous tutorial, and same thing.
Pareil,
I place
en fait,
it in first
mettre,
position.
Je vais toujours le mettre devant. Alors, si j'y pense tout à
Maybe if we have time, we'll do a small test with the mono to stereo first and si then the autotune. Usually you get a weird chorus effect.
Ensuite, l'autotune, ça
it's very bizarre. Personally, I think it's destructive and not especially interesting.
Peut-être que vous, ça vous intéressera. Allez, on va voir le best.
Let's see the plugin. I just write auto. In the plugin search bar,
moteur de recherche de plugin, et je vais.
And then I click on AutoTune Live VST.
Alors qu'est-ce que c'est?
So what is this?
C'est la partie,
it's the simplest part of AutoTune. Basically, with AutoTune, the complete version of AutoTune, we have a function.
On a,
here we haven't, so I can't show you. Which is a kind of a Cubase Vario Audio, where you can move your notes where you want, manually or automatically.
De le faire automatiquement, directement, nos prises.
It does work with the vocal record or an instrument either.
Qu'est-ce qu'on retrouve?
What do we have?
Dans les paramètres,
we have some different principal settings and we're gonna see all of them.
Alors déjà, on a
first, we have the input type.
D'entrée.
Donc là, here we talk about an alto tenor voice, not an instrument.
Alto tenor. Donc, de base,
basically, soprano is a high-pitched voice, usually a high-pitched woman voice. Alto tenor is, for example, a medium high man voice.
Medium, par exemple.
Low male is for a deep man voice.
Ça va plutôt être une voix basse d'homme.
Instrument is used on a bass, for example, and it's only for monophonic instruments, which are instruments where you play only one note at the time.
Pour corriger une basse.
And bass is only for bass. I use it often on some bass to make it sound right.
Donc nous,
for us, it will be alto tenor. Then we'll start with making a loop.
Donc je vais faire une petite boucle.
I will make a loop at the beginning of the chorus.
Là, donc je sélectionne.
I select my patterns and I press P.
Et
and then
j'appuie sur la touche diviser.
I do my loop with a click on here,
donc je clique ici,
here or here.
On va écouter.
We will listen what we get if we don't change any parameters except for the input type. You can make your online show.
You can show your face at all, face to face. Alors là,
so there it's in native mode, meaning I haven't changed anything so far. So now, what I'm going to do is to put the retune speed at its highest level. What is the retune speed? It's how fast AutoTune will react on each note. So here we have 0 milliseconds between each one. There is not enough time for an escalation from one note to another. You will see that it does change everything straight away.
Donc là, on entend
clairement. So here we can clearly listen what's going on.
Parmi le deuxième paramètre qui va être ultra.
The second parameter was very important, the tracking.
Enfin, quand on parle de tracking, on
with the tracking, you can choose between two modes.
Du signal brut ou pas. On va choisir.
So we have two modes. And the first is relaxed.
Soit en mode relaxed.
It's inverted. I don't really know why.
Mais soit en mode relax. Donc les plus doux.
It's more smooth.
Soit en mode.
Or you have the 100% mode.
La valeur là.
And with this mode, the là, correction is full.
À balle. You can make your online show. You can show your face at all, face to face. Donc si on veut l'utiliser dans
if we want to use it in a traditional way, we will, for example, set up the retune speed at 20 milliseconds. We talk
par exemple,
in milliseconds.
À, retune speed, pardon, à 20. Voilà, on est en millisecondes.
Let's listen.
You can make your online show. You can show your face at all, face to face. You really know. It's only 'cause you're.
Là, c'est déjà pas mal.
So it's not bad already, là, but there is still something wrong. Within the notes Autotune just placed, some of them are not right. And the big part of the work is there. It's to find the right notes and to learn how to use all the parameters correctly.
Alors, dans le select pitch
here we have the select pitch reference. So we choose if we take the left source or the right source in a stereo signal.
La référence. Si on prend plutôt de la source de gauche ou celle de droite, ça n'a pas vraiment.
To be fair, it's not very important. We only choose if we follow left side or right side.
On choisit si on suit le côté gauche ou si on suit le côté droit. Ensuite, on va.
Then we have in this part
on va
the possibility to set up automatically autotune. If we know the song's key, for example, here I composed everything with a chord track.
Alors là, par
I have a huge tutorial about it. I encourage you to have a look at it if you don't know this.
Gros tutoriel là-dessus, je vous invite à le regarder si vous ne connaissez pas. Et la musique que j'ai composée
so here,
de la piste à cordes.
We can see that my key is in E flat major.
Donc le scale, le K, pardon. Après c'est le scale, c'est la.
Then you have the scale.
C'est un.
But my key is in E flat major.
Donc un mi bémol majeur. C'est pareil pour les musiciens. Donc si je mets en
so here I click on EB in the key section
majeur,
and then on major in the scale section. Let's see what we get.
Et vous voyez qu'automatiquement,
and you can see that Autotune choose some unique notes to play with regarding of the song's key.
Qui correspondent donc à la gamme du morceau.
You can make your online show.
Et là,
and there, déjà it's already way better.
Voilà, donc ça,
so that's one of the first parameters, and then we have the scale detune.
Tout simplement,
to simply detune the autotune's tuning.
Pas concrètement la
usually,
voix,
it's set up on the A reference.
C'est-à-dire que normalement, là, il est
440 Hz. You know that the A is the reference note.
Là, c'est la note de référence pour beaucoup de choses.
So, if we decrease it,
you can make your online show. You can show.
Eh ben, il corrige.
It does correct the voice with the detune we choose.
Là, on a en Hertz et là, on a en pourcent. Donc, je remets à zéro.
I put it back to zero with the command key on Mac and control on PC. And I do a left click. Automatically.
Ensuite, parmi.
Then we have the float length.
On a
and
le
formant.
Float length, le formant.
And to alors, be able to use the float length, you need to activate the formant.
Activer le formant. Qu'est-ce que c'est
so what is this?
Là, il n'y a pas de modification, on est à 100.
It's simply to
c'est
choose the tone of voice,
si
whether it's a wailing voice or a very deep voice.
Criard, plutôt voix de tête ou plutôt la voix très très grave comme ça.
So with this you will be able to make it cheaper if that's what you want.
Le vocal.
So it's simply to change the tone. That's it.
Caverneux. Là on est plus.
There it's higher.
Attendez et là.
And there,
en fait, c'est comme ça. C'est comme si on avait une trachée.
It's like if we had bigger vocal cords.
Longue. Bah, du coup, voilà, si on met 176.
At 176, we have bigger ones, but
évidemment.
It also distorts the voice, obviously.
Donc,
so
je désactive.
I disable the formant because we don't want it right now.
Donc bon, on va commencer, voilà, vraiment.
So before we go into the heart of the topic, you already understood that autotune can react in accordance to a key.
De gamme à la clé. Hein. Voilà. Ensuite.
Then we have all this part. We've seen it already. Where you have to, where you have the key choice and the possibility to detune the voice.
Quand on est sur une piste stéréo.
The reference source when you're using a stereo source.
La gamme et la possibilité.
The key choice
en lui-même.
And the detune of the autotune.
La grande complexité.
The most difficult part for many of you, it's how to find the right notes when you're not a musician. And that's what we are going to see next. There is different solution for that, and we will see how to fix those problems.
Pour l'instant, on va laisser donc.
So far, we will leave the Richard speed at, let's say, 10 milliseconds. You can make your line
show. You can show your... Comme ça, ça s'entend un peu.
So like that, we can hear it a little bit.
Quelles sont les différentes méthodes?
So I go back to default setting and we will see different methods to choose our notes.
Différentes méthodes pour choisir ces notes. Alors, première.
First thing to see.
On a
we have the keyboard here, who shows us which notes are playing.
Quelles sont les notes qui sont jouées? Donc là, j'ai remis à zéro, donc les notes.
There, I came back to zero, so the notes are not right anymore. I will simply use the keyboard edit here.
En cliquant ou en ne pas cliquant.
You click or you don't click.
On clique gauche. Le keyboard edit.
The keyboard edit is just to choose if I remove a note or if I add one.
Je l'ajoute. On va rester sur le mode.
So we will stay in the remove mode. So within all the notes that AutoTune is allowed to play, we will be able to remove some of them. We go to the beginning. Let's try with the retune speed at its maximum. So we will see which notes are wrong.
Donc celle-là, déjà, on sait qu'on n'en veut pas.
We know that this one is wrong.
Alors là, je crois que ça va être celle-là.
I think it's this one.
Oh non, c'est pas ça.
It's not this one.
Celle-là.
Maybe this one.
Peut-être celle-là aussi.
Maybe this one too.
Voilà.
Here we go.
Peut-être enlever celle-là aussi.
Maybe we can take this one off too. So I move my cursor with plus and less from my num key to go back where it's high pitched.
Et là,
and there, so far, we just took off the notes we didn't want in our song.
Donc je peux le faire.
I can do it right here.
Sur la totalité du truc.
Mais we can also choose here.
On a la possibilité aussi
an option to make sure those notes are removed from all octaves.
Soit sur la totalité des octaves.
In case of the voice go down or go lower, for example.
Donc là, on voit que.
So there, we can see that we get a result pretty easily.
Deuxième méthode.
So now the second method.
Deuxième méthode. Donc
it's a method we've seen previously.
Celle qu'on a vue tout à l'heure.
It's to change our key. Simply.
La possibilité de choisir une gamme. Donc moi, je suis en mi bémol majeur.
Here I am in E flat major.
D'ailleurs, la gamme relative in la dièse ici, c'est la dièse majeure. Oh non, ça c'est la gamme pardon du refrain. Soit. Et là, il nous reste.
So what's left? Only the notes were from the same key.
Qui font partie de
that
la
means that all the notes were not from this key are automatically removed.
Ça revient au même que tout à l'heure.
It's the same thing that we did before.
Donc jusque là,
so far, so good.
Ensuite, il y a une autre méthode.
Then there is another method, which is to learn the information from MIDI.
Ça va être.
It will be a little bit more complex to understand, but very easy to do. I've done a test before. I will simply delete it first.
Donc, qu'est-ce qui se passe?
What's going on here?
Qu'est-ce qui se passe? AutoTune nous propose.
AutoTune also allows us to work from a MIDI track. Basically, it's just like saying to AutoTune, look, voilà. You will learn from the MIDI track which key it is.
Quelle est la gamme?
And automatically, AutoTune will choose a note in accordance with the key, thanks to the MIDI track.
Dessiné petit à petit grâce à une piste MIDI. Alors pour l'utiliser,
so to use it, first thing to do is to add.
Je vais ajouter
a MIDI track,
MIDI,
and I will name it.
Je vais l'appeler
AutoTune.
Si vous avez,
if you have a chord track,
si vous avez...
So, if you have a contract, it will be very simple.
Donc là, ça va être très simple. Vous allez faire
you will commande do command plus right click
ou control,
or control
droit,
plus right click on Windows
pour aller dans piste
on
d'accord.
Here to go on chord track and make
et,
chord symbols.
Créer des symboles d'accord. Donc automatiquement, il va
automatically
toutes les notes
all the chords
en,
là, we see up there
ici, enfin toutes les notes, toutes les tous les accords qu'on voit là,
il will va be turned into a MIDI chord. Then my MIDI track,
okay.
I need to send it into AutoTune.
Ensuite,
automatically, MIDI, AutoTune just created the MIDI in. Otherwise, we could not do it.
MIDI, chose qui est tout à fait
so,
logique, sinon on pourrait pas le faire.
For the routing, I will choose any as an out to make sure
sortie,
it's connected to all channels.
J'utilise tous les canaux. Et là, je vais aller dans lead, MIDI in. Alors,
what I have to do now is to activate the function learn from MIDI. So far, now nothing changed.
Ça change,
all notes are removed.
On a toujours toutes les notes de remover. Et là, je vais.
And then I go to the singing verse.
Chant couplet.
Insert AutoTune Live VST.
Du coup, c'est apparu. Et vous allez voir.
And you will see while playing from the beginning
that
AutoTune take off some notes.
You can make your online show. You can show your face at all, face to face. You really.
Moi, je vois qu'un octave.
I'll show you one octave.
You can make your online show. You can show your face at all, face to face. You really know.
Donc vous voyez que
so
là,
you can see that all the notes were gray or the notes we're gonna use with AutoTune.
Dans l'AutoTune.
Show.
Et automatiquement,
automatically, AutoTune will replace in accordance to that.
Donc ça, c'est la méthode la
so
plus simple.
So that's the easiest way to do it. We can also go further in the song, but it will always follow what's playing.
En fait, ça va
it's always efficient.
Ce qui va être joué. Sachez que vous
know that you can put many MIDI sources in that MIDI track.
MIDI dans cette piste MIDI.
So,
en faisant tout
for example.
Par exemple, alors là, j'ai
activate my grid.
J'appuie sur la touche Alt.
Then I click on Alt
pas,
and I drag my pattern to my MIDI track.
Je vais faire un glisser. Je lâche la souris. Voilà. Et là, j'ai rajouté des notes.
I just added some notes.
Alors là, par contre, c'est.
But now it's not the same autotune anymore.
Je vais mettre.
So I insert one in the chorus singing.
C'est vrai que c'est séparé.
Those one are separated. I go
live.
To AutoTune Live.
Ça suffira. Il est là.
There it is.
Et je vais faire pareil. Donc,
and I do exactly the same thing.
MIDI.
Learn from MIDI.
Et cette fois-ci, je vais envoyer ma piste MIDI.
And I send my MIDI track. You need as much MIDI track as AutoTune track. Automatically. If you don't have a MIDI track who defines all your song,
votre musique,
you can put
déjà,
everything into the autotune.
Dans cette, auto-tune.
So
on
with
enlève,
an association of
plus,
all your instruments, bass, arpeggiator, synth,
les éléments comme la basse,
automatically, autotune will find what's wrong.
Alors là, j'ai perdu le point, excusez-moi. Hop. Lui, automatiquement, il va trouver... il va trouver ce qui va pas.
And the vocal will be changed in accordance to that.
Le vocal en fonction de ça. Bon, piste d'accord, je
so chord track, MIDI track.
Ça,
I've done a huge tutorial about it. If you want to watch it, just write chords or MIDI in the website search bar.
Vous le trouverez facilement.
We'll find it easily.
Voilà, voilà. Donc ça, c'était la deuxième méthode.
So that was the second method.
La troisième méthode. Donc on enlève
the first method is to take off the notes manually.
Donc là, j'enlève ça, par exemple. Hop.
I do it just there.
Du coup, ça y est là. Là, du coup, hop. Voilà, je remets en mode normal.
I go back in the initial setting.
Voilà, du coup, c'est comme s'il marchait plus. Bon.
So it's like if it doesn't work, the easiest thing to do is go back to initial. So just close AutoTune and open it again.
Et je rebalance l'AutoTune, hop, pour avoir.
Just open it back.
Qui repart de zéro. Voilà, donc ça c'était la troisième méthode.
So that was the third method.
La première méthode, c'est d'enlever les notes à la volée.
So let's remind that the first method is to do a left click and take off the notes. Second method is to choose the key easily.
C'est celle-là, c'est celle qui permet.
And the third method is this one.
Quatrième méthode, ça va être la possibilité de.
And before we see the fourth method, I delete this, I delete everything that was into the MIDI track.
Ça va être la possibilité de.
So this method is about playing in real time the notes that we want to be sung by the singer.
Que le chanteur chante. Alors par exemple, hop.
For example,
je me mets là.
I go there.
Alors il y a beaucoup de choses.
There is many things.
Pour l'instant, je ferme tout ça.
For now, I'll just close it.
Donc H et G pour zoomer ou dézoomer.
H and G to zoom or dézoom.
Donc là, par exemple, je vais corriger tout ça.
For example, I will correct everything.
Ça va être un petit peu compliqué. Ça
just this pattern,
long.
It will be a little bit faire, long, but I can do it.
On va faire à peu près n'importe quoi.
Let's have fun and do anything.
En ré bémol, en ré dièse majeur.
So I go on my original key.
De là. Et par exemple, on va lui dire chante.
And for example, we will just say to him sing this, so this note.
Bon, je sélectionne la note. Hop, je prends mon crayon, c'est plus simple pour moi.
I will use a pen, it's easier for me.
Hop.
This one, hop. This one,
si c'est juste,
this one. I don't know if it's right, but I think so.
Et automatiquement, l'autotune.
And automatically, autotune.
Il va. Si je le renvoie. Vers le bon.
Autotune, if I send him back to the right track.
Autotune, parce que là,
so verse singing, autotune live VST.
Si configuré.
So for this track.
Okay. Hop. Là, je vais faire donc.
I will not use a land scale from MIDI anymore, note, but MIDI. Target note from MIDI.
Note en fonction du MIDI. Et je reste sur all octave.
And I'll stay on all octaves. Let's listen.
Alors là. Je suis beaucoup trop haut.
I'm a little bit too high. Let's go down.
On va descendre.
Just there.
Hop. Bon, normalement, c'est pas du tout la figure rythmique. Hein. Alors là, vous voyez, il a du mal.
So, he's struggling a little bit.
Bon, on va pas mettre sur tous les octaves, on met sur.
We don't gonna use all octaves.
C'est ça qui est.
That's why we have a little problem here. You can show your face. Face to
face. You really know. It's a leak. Alors ça, c'est.
So with this fourth method, it's the first way to do it. It's pretty easy so far.
Envoyer des notes.
And that's the way to send MIDI notes to AutoTune.
C'est assez simple. On va pas dire que c'est très compliqué.
Pretty easy, not that hard to do.
Savoir rentrer mélodiquement.
But we need to know how to write melodically what the singer is doing.
Nickel.
To make sure to do a right correction.
C'est aller.
What can I do eventually is to go there.
Et dire, voilà, double-cliquer sur la séquence.
Double-click on the pattern. I do pitch and warp.
Dire quelles sont les notes justes ou celles qui le sont.
And
pas.
Cubase will tell me which notes are right and which notes are not.
Donc, attention, hein, il faut vraiment.
So be careful, just double-click there and go to Vary Audio.
Dans Vary Audio ici.
Pitch and warp from Vary Audio.
Extraire le MIDI.
Extract MIDI.
Seulement un, voilà, on va faire ça.
There we go, we just do this.
Avec autotune. Et je clique sur OK.
So I click on OK.
Alors, il me les a mis sur nouvelle.
It just added the notes on a new MIDI track.
Commande sur Mac.
So I press Command on Mac or Control on Windows, and I drag it into my autotune track. Automatically, Cubase will create.
M'a créé.
Cubase just created my vocal melody.
Et là, par exemple, je.
And there, for example, I realize that those notes are wrong.
Alors, on va revoir le début.
Really.
Voilà. Alors, hop.
I use control to don't move the note. We have another possibility. For example, okay, I will mute exemple, those notes. And for example, ask autotune to don't correct
par
those
exemple,
ones.
Ça, je veux pas que ce soit corrigé. Donc, le problème,
the only problem we have,
c'est que c'est toujours
it's
la même note.
Always the same note. Why?
Parce que tout simplement,
simply because
là,
that our keybomb mode is in latch, in latch mode.
Autotune va prendre en compte.
That means autotune will take the last note we've been played and keep going to play this one.
Replacer sur la même note.
And replace on the same note. So we will not change.
Là, si on écoute, en effet, on a toujours.
So if we listen, we're gonna have the same note.
Si je me mets en momentary.
If I change to momentary in the keyboard mode,
ça sera plus du tout la même chose.
It will not be the same thing logically. So basically, autotune will not act all the time. It will not react all the time. Only when a note is given to him.
Alors, faut peut-être.
So first, maybe yet. Go back to default. Everything back to zero.
On va. Ça, c'est une question que je ne me suis pas posée, mais c'est vrai que là, c'est un peu embêtant. On va remettre en mode normal.
Let's go back to normal mode.
Momentary.
Momentary.
On règle d'office comme ça.
And we set it up like that. Let's listen.
Et par contre,
I just connected back to autotune.
Couplé, voilà. Couplé.
The verse singing. You can show your
face at all, face. Donc ça, c'est mon chant
d'origine. That's my original singing.
Et là, par contre,
and there, automatically,
il intervient.
He will react only on the note we gave to him. Let's check with placing a C, for example.
Et c'est bien.
So that's right.
Par contre, le reste.
But the rest, let's listen.
Ne bouge pas. C'est-à-dire que c'est.
It doesn't move.
Instantané.
It's instant.
Au moment où on attribue une note.
For the moment voilà, we choose a note for autotune, automatically, it will react only
voilà.
At
donc,
this moment.
Ça, c'était vraiment pour les quatre.
So we just in four way to use autotune, and now
non,
we will see all parameters of autotune. So I will just delete this track.
Et allez, donc c'était la piste MIDI.
That was a MIDI track. I just done a right click and delete selected tracks. And I will load a brand new autotune.
Voilà, live. Donc
so I go back to alto tenor.
Et
and let's see all the parameters in detail.
Alors,
first, let's do a quick reminder.
Singulier. Donc là,
here you have the voice type
de
with input type.
Qu'on y met, hein, le input type. Le tracking.
The tracking,
c'est,
to use autotune fully or to use a slight correction.
Donc là, c'est pas le cas. Ou.
Depend of what you need, of course.
En process.
100% or 0% of autotune.
Le gauche-droit qui permet.
The left-right for the reference source.
Référence pour une piste stéréo.
In a stereo track, of course.
Donc c'est la.
Here we have the key.
La gamme.
We've seen it already.
Bon, la nuance chromatique. La nuance harmonique, pardon. La possibilité de tuner des.
We have the tune and detune possibility.
Le timbre de voix.
To change the tone of voice regarding of your
là,
vocal cords type.
Ce que l'autotune comprend.
Here we have what autotune is analyzing from the signal. So basically,
donc,
when a note is playing, it shows us the correction.
Et ça va être l'écart de justesse en fonction de cette note-là.
The correction gap in real time.
Ensuite, on a la possibilité de remover ou.
Then we have the possibility to remove or bypass some notes.
Bon, ça c'est pour rester.
Here it's to be in major, minor, old, etc. All those options.
Tout à zéro. Donc nous, on va se mettre.
Us, we're gonna stay on the key.
Puisque bon.
Because we can do it.
Déjà, automatiquement.
And automatically, he added some notes.
Le return speed.
And then we have the return speed, which is how fast the autotune react. You can make your online show.
You can show your face at all.
If you want something more natural, we're gonna choose a 20 for the return speed.
Pas mal calculé, 20 millisecondes. Pas mal calculé.
It's not too bad for a real singing. You can make
can show your face at all, face to face. You really know.
Ensuite,
then we have another possibility.
Alors là, la possibilité
d'humaniser. It's to humanize or not humanize.
Alors, faut savoir que
bon là par exemple, if you leave your mouth
je l'ai étudié.
On humanize.
Il faut savoir que si on reste sur le bouton,
Autotune will give you
a
small definition.
On va voir apparaître.
Autotune says de, add realism to sustain notes at high reaching speed.
Notes and resume. Voilà quoi. Bon, en gros, ça va être.
So
si on est
if
fond,
you push at almost the top,
ou pas,
you can humanize the voice.
À fond qu'on va l'entendre.
You can make your online show.
Voilà.
There we go.
D'humaniser.
It is to give the impression that it is real. It's not too modified. It's human.
Si je mets à zéro.
So if I go back to zero.
You can make your online show. You can show your face at all.
Là, voilà, par exemple, sur
so there we can hear that the at all goes straight up.
Qu'il y a eu un
it's like being on some stairs.
Dans la note,
it's not progressive between two notes.
Progressive entre deux notes. Ensuite, on a la possibilité.
Then we have the possibility to exaggerate the natural vibrato or not.
Donc avec le natural.
With the natural vibrato.
Par exemple,
for example, if you want the vibrato at zero, we just turn it down.
Quasi à néant.
Almost at zero.
You can make your online show. You can show your face at all, face to face. You really know.
Mais du coup, il va y avoir un problème.
But we're gonna have a problem if we turn it up.
L'accentuer.
You can make your online show. You can show your face at all, face to face. You really know.
Voilà, le problème, c'est que
the issue is if you turn it up or if you turn it down, the notes will be changed.
Parce que le vibrato,
a vibrato is a wobble, so the note is going up, is going down on the same wave.
Autour de la note de référence.
Just around the reference note, the note you play at the moment. For example,
voilà, show. Par exemple, si on prend show.
If we take show.
Elle nous a corrigé.
It just corrected
si,
it.
Si on en rajoute trop, automatiquement.
If we have too much vibrato, automatically we will go note. Out of the note.
Alors je vais pousser à fond.
Let's push it up.
Pas là, parce que je suis pas sûr.
Online show. You can show your face at all.
Voilà,
here we go.
Là.
Here the vibrato is so exaggerated. That we are not in the same note anymore.
On est plus autour
it's another
note.
One.
En fait, on passe sur une autre note. Carrément.
So,
lui,
autotune
lui,
is correcting the new note.
Donc, il y a une possibilité de remédier à ça, qu'on soit
so, to fix that issue, we can use the targeting in your vibrato.
Qu'est-ce que c'est? En fait,
so, what is this?
Ça va être,
autotune will target the reference note.
Lui va reconnaître la
so
note.
Autotune will recognize the note and it will make sure that it will wobble around this one
pas de la note
and not the new note will just been added with a vibrato.
Plus ou moins naturel qu'on aura défini.
Natural or not.
Si j'appuie sur ce touche,
whatever.
En toute logique, je suis quand même
so if I press it, I'm supposed to stay on the reference note which just been analyzed and just been corrected.
Alors là, c'est quand même
well,
difficile.
It's a bit
lui.
Tough for autotune because I put so much vibrato, but if I turn it down a little bit,
on va se mettre là.
Let's go back here.
On voit que automatiquement,
we can see that automatically the vibrato is less pushed.
Et si je mets en plus,
and if I turn the vibrato down again.
Du vibrato. On se retrouve.
We get a flat note, flat, hein. And that's what we want.
C'est un petit peu le principe. Donc le targeting, en fait, ça permet.
Targeting
de,
takes some refining. It doesn't work just like that.
Le targeting, ça permet.
But for example, if your note is a C, with targeting, you will be able to say to autotune, look, stay on the C note, wobble around it, and don't go to any other. Whether
dire, bon, alors
if you turn the vibrato up or if you turn it down, it will stay on the same note. It will wobble around.
Vibrato, tu le calcules autour du
so those elements are complementary.
Sont complémentaires. Donc ensuite, parmi les paramètres, on a... alors là, je vais remettre...
So, normal. I go back to normal.
Je laisse...
Allez, je vais I will not humanize. I leave it like that just to get a kind of future sound. So, we'll see other parameters. We just seen this already. So, we can use a scale to learn from the key.
Depuis la gamme. Et la nuance harmonique, soit on a
pas. Or we learn from the notes.
Là, c'est ce qu'on joue.
So basically, do we choose to play it like the note was playing?
C'est-à-dire
or do we choose to play it on the octave?
Comment dire? Ce que.
That means in that case,
on laisse quand
that
même,
we leave the vocal move from an octave to another one.
D'une octave à l'autre, et en respectant ça. Ensuite, on a le keyboard edit. Alors ça, petite parenthèse.
There we have the sample rate. So it's not really a parameter, it's more like a display.
En fait, c'est pas vraiment un paramètre, c'est un affichage qui permet de dire.
I also got a tutorial about it, named How to Understand the Numerical Signal. And in this tutorial, I explain everything about the sample rate. It's an important notion in music and sound. I encourage you to watch it if you don't know anything about it.
Ensuite, keyboard edit.
Then we have the keyboard edit. So, are we removing a note or are we bypassing notes? Usually, we leave it on remove. We have the keyboard mode. We seen it just before. It's for when you work from a MIDI track.
Il joue les notes, voilà.
So it's to say, are we correcting when the note from the MIDI track is playing?
Sur la piste MIDI. Je vous rappelle, je l'ai montré tout à l'heure.
We've just seen it before. Or are we correcting all the time?
Voilà, donc momentary.
So momentary, when you have a single MIDI note,
latch, c'est en fonction
and latch for the last note who've been played.
Ensuite, on a...
Then,
tout ça, le reste, on l'a vu.
We have all the rest, we just... we've seen it already.
Très rarement.
Options, we use it very rarely.
Dans le cas d'un...
Maybe in the case where you have a controller, but honestly, I don't see the interest.
Pourquoi pas,
why not?
Live, je sais pas.
If you play live, whatever.
C'est une partie que je vais pas forcément.
I won't really explain this part. It's not that hard to understand.
Canal, MIDI. En
you choose a MIDI canal according to your controller. Oui. I've got a tuto about that too.
Je vous invite à aller voir. Et ensuite, on a donc ce.
So what's left?
Ce petit.
We have this window. And this window gives you the possibility to create a vibrato. So let's say that we've got something very corrected. We don't gonna have vibrato anymore.
Un petit peu.
Just a little bit.
Je diminue.
I turn it down.
Donc là, on voit
so we can see that we have less vibrato and some notes have changed.
On va pouvoir rajouter un vibrato.
So we can add a vibrato, more or less natural.
Donc on va commencer pour create vibrato.
So to begin, we go to create vibrato.
Cliquez ici.
And we're gonna choose the sine wave.
Sinus,
usually that's what we use.
Sinusoïdal. Donc une sine wave, une courbe vague.
Maybe we will see the other options later, but I find it very numerical.
On testera tout à l'heure si vous voulez.
But we can check later.
Je vais, moi, me mettre plutôt dans mode traditionnel.
I will use a traditional mode.
Rate, c'est en fréquence.
What is rate?
C'est en kilo.
With rate, we talk about frequency. So it's a value in kilo. We need to know that a vibrato, a sinusoidal curve, is more or less fast. So it could be a short wave or a longer one. It depends on the frequency that the curve will generate. So for example, if I turn it down to the minimum and I leave the rest to the maximum, but not the formant, you can make your line show. You can show your face at all, face to face, you really know. We're gonna try to find a pattern with a longer note.
Faut vraiment que je trouve une note.
I really need a longer note.
On va rester là-dessus.
Let's stay with this one.
It's only 'cause you're...
And I will create a loop from ear to ear. Hop.
Donc là, le
vibrato, so here the vibrato is not pushed at his maximum.
Qu'est-ce qu'il y a?
So what do we have in terms of parameters? We have onset delay.
En fait, c'est quand.
Basically, it's to design when the vibrato will start.
Décalage, hein, dans le temps.
So we can say to the vibrato start straight away. So I turn it to zero.
C'est des millisecondes aussi.
That's millisecond too. Donc là, I put back the natural vibrato, the basic one.
Et là, ce qu'il y a, c'est que la courbe est.
What happened here? My curve is very large, but my note very short.
Je vais augmenter là, par exemple.
So I will increase my rate to 5 kilos.
Soyons fous.
And you will see what's the impact.
Là, vous l'entendez.
You can hear it.
Si. Je pousse ça.
If I push this,
il arrive pas de suite.
It doesn't come now, so I can keep going to push.
On peut continuer.
We can keep going to push.
Vous voyez que il vient.
You see that it comes step by step.
Je diminue un petit peu la vitesse.
I turn the speed down a little bit.
Pour que ce soit plus agréable à l'écoute.
Here we go.
Ensuite, la variation.
Then we have variation. So what is this? I turn it down again to make sure we see really how the vibrato is working. So variation is a random algorithm. And it will decide if the vibrato will be the same all the time or not at all. So if we push it a lot, we have a lot of variation. If we turn it down, we won't have much.
Voyez,
you see, the vibrato is not the same all the time. We don't have the same curve all the time.
Approximativement autour de.
We choose between a small variation, random, or a bigger one. And let's see what happens if I turn it back to zero.
Ça veut dire que.
It will be always the same curve. The curve won't move.
Donc je remets avec la valeur.
So I go back to initial value with a right click and command on Mac or control on PC.
Ensuite, on a.
Then we have the onset rate.
Alors, qu'est-ce que c'est? C'est pareil, c'est
and the onset rate is in millisecond too.
Quelque chose qui va interagir avec ça. C'est en fait quand.
Basically, it's
combien de temps
how much time the vibrato will need to get to its maximum amplitude.
Maximum, c'est-à-dire que le vibrato, en fait.
So the vibrato will wobble a little bit at the beginning, according to the onset delay.
Et puis il va.
And it will increase step by step.
Cet effet-là, hein.
We can hear the wobble even more.
Voilà. Et ça, ça va être ben, quand. Il va atteindre.
And that, en fait, it's when the vibrato get to its maximum amplitude.
L'amplitude maximum du vibrato.
As default is set up on 500 milliseconds, but we're gonna push it a little bit. It's smooth at the beginning and it gets stronger. If I push to the maximum.
On a même pas le temps,
it doesn't even have the time to take the note, to take the variation. So if I turn it back to the minimum, we got it straight away.
La valeur
initial value is 500,
là, on va pousser
and we're gonna push it a little bit.
Plus agréable. Donc jusque là, rien de très complexe.
So far, so good. We can get easily a natural result just with those parameters. Then we have the pitch amount.
En fait,
I said it previously, the vibrato is a variation around the note.
Qui définit le vibrato. Ben ça va être.
And the pitch amount, it's how much the note will be detuned or not.
Normalement, elle devrait.
At zero, the note is not too detuned.
Ryan.
A very light vibrato.
Mais à fond.
And at the maximum.
Ouais, ça peut créer des effets sympas, mais en fait...
So we can have some funny effects like that,
initiale,
but the idea is to refine until we get a realistic vibrato.
Peaufiner pour faire en sorte que le vibrato soit plus ou moins réaliste. Et ensuite...
And then we have the formant amount.
The formant amount. En fait, le vibrato est.
With the formant amount, we can have more or less vocal timbre.
Par exemple, là, j'ai un petit truc.
But first, what's a vocal timbre?
We
all have a bunch of harmonics in our voice. When we talk, when we sing, when we whisper, and all together, they define our vocal timbre.
Définir le timbre de ma voix. En fait,
and what's a voice basically? It's a fundamental note. When I speak now, I'm always on the same note.
Ou alors si je fais.
If I do, there is a reference note, and behind,
c'est pas quoi, là, d'ailleurs.
There is a lot of tiny pieces of voice, and they define the voice as a note. They define what's the difference between a voice and another one.
La voix, tout simplement, qui permet de différencier une voix par rapport à l'autre, hein, en fonction de nos caractéristiques biologiques. Et peut-être aussi notre
it tête. Also depends of our biological.
Ah,
if we're tired, if we drink alcohol,
fumeurs,
or if we are smokers,
ça,
usually smokers have a broken voice in the
donc,
morning.
Ça c'est la possibilité,
for example.
D'exagérer ou pas.
So the formant amount is a possibility to exaggerate the voice timbre or not. If I turn it to zero, we will lose some timbre.
C'est très léger.
It's very light.
On a
it's a little bit more high pitched.
En fait, dans la voix, tout simplement. Si on remet à zéro.
Let's go back to zero.
Ou alors,
or just a little bit.
C'est compliqué, hein.
It's complex.
Là, par exemple, c'est timbré, mais c'est dans le vibrato.
You need to focus on the vibrato. It's about
c'est,
having more vocal timbre on the vibrato or not.
Et là,
so at 100%,
à 100%, on dirait qu'il y a plus
the voice feels more enraged.
Plus d'air.
More air.
Là, si je mets au minimum.
And to the minimum.
Le vibrato,
the vibrato feels deeper, but
très, très
that's
léger,
very slight.
Dit,
however, it's a good tool. It depends on dit, what kind of vocal timbre you need to record.
Classe, suivant si la personne est très timbrée ou pas. Bon, maintenant, on va voir le dernier.
So now we're going to see the last parameter we haven't seen yet.
Donc ça, c'est la forme.
So that is the vibrato waveform.
Du vibrato. Donc si on
if we choose square, for example,
ça va être quoi?
C'est un it will be a square signal, a square waveform.
Ça va faire un signal carré.
Let's listen.
Alors, si on le pousse...
So, if we push it a lot,
par exemple, je mets,
and if we increase the variation,
je rajoute un peu de variation quand même. En fait, il n'y a pas de courbe.
It's not a wave anymore.
Escalier, hein?
It's like stairs.
Et après, on a sawtooth.
And then we have sawtooth.
Les saw, en fait, généralement, c'est les dents de scie, hein, tout simplement. Donc, au lieu d'avoir...
It's like a saw.
Ça, on va plutôt être...
It's a triangular signal.
Hop là. C'est une forme triangulaire, comme on dit. Et ça, en fait,
it's something we could use on an instrument
vraiment,
or for really distort the voice.
Hein. Par exemple... Voilà.
It's really for distort or add some slight effects on the voice.
Sur la voix. Voilà.
Écoutez, so, now we've seen everything in the tutorial, and now I'm sure you're ready to use perfectly AutoTune Live.
Pour rappel,
so, quick reminder, AutoTune Live is interesting because first,
Cubase,
it's cheap.
Si vous êtes utilisateur de Cubase,
in terms of price, it's interesting. It's way cheaper than the complete version.
Déjà possibilité avec le Vario.
You have a kind of Vario Audio integrated, even if with Cubase you already have one.
Directement dans notre chantillonneur, dans notre séquence là, comme on l'a vu tout à l'heure.
We've seen it before.
Royal aussi là dessus. Du coup.
Personally, bon, moi, I think that it's a good compromise between the full version
là, on est quand même,
and the Antares Evo EFX version,
et,
with way more parameters and possibilities.
Lui coûte pas très cher, mais qui est très
Evo FX is really cheap,
et,
but is limited.
L'autotune.
And the full version of autotune, maybe there is some parameters you won't use.
Qui
even if it's more complete, maybe you won't have to use everything. So.
L'utilité. Voilà.
And also, there is a possibility to use it live on stage.
Les artistes,
and trust me, that's something artists appreciate a lot.
Tutoriel vous aura plu. Je vous
I really hope you enjoyed this video. See you soon for a new tutorial at www.myvpschool.com. Bye bye.